You've got to engage him mentally. Because when you don't engage him mentally and you go into survival mode,
right.
He goes into survival mode. You're not doing anything to support or help him. So what happens is he starts taking care of himself.
Right.
So you're not taking care of me, so I'm going to take care of myself.
So what would you say would be a good... Okay, so we start to feel...
All right.
If he starts growing...
He starts to pop up in his head.
Shut down.
I would take the rein, I'd move his hips,
head down.
Move his shoulder, I would do something to get him away from the direction he's thinking about going. Exactly. If he locks down, then you take him the other way. You know, people will get so dead set on, because you've got to think about this. When you're extending, all the horse is thinking about is trying to get through the moment of what you're asking them to do. How do they get through that? That moment. Well, and it's all about how we explain it. And if you get in there and you, some horses can take it, some horses can't. Those are the ones that we kick to the curb and say they're no good. Like, it doesn't matter where it is, whether it's cutting horses, jumping horses, dressage horses, roping horses, barrel horses, I don't care what it is, you'll see people run through 100 to get one because they don't fit into the program. Well, what happens is when they don't fit into the program, people get frustrated. People get frustrated at the horse because the horse beat them. The horse thought a little faster than they did, reacted a little better. Well, what happened was the horse at some point reached out for their help and they weren't there. So the horse did what it normally would do, just like us. I'm not going to become a victim. I'm going to take care of myself.
Right.
So if you just stay up there and try to survive and get through that, he's going to get through it. You may just not be attached. So what does that mean? He may run off. He may be bucking. If we know that the horse is physically sound, we went through the ideas of anything from the toes to the teeth to the ears to the tip of the tail, and the horse is, and it's just been nothing but a mental idea of breakdown. He's going to get through it. You may not, but he will. He is not going to become a victim willingly. Okay? Well, that's what happens with us. We don't understand that because we live in a world of rainbows and fuzzy kittens and fluffy horses and unicorns. Because we think, well, nobody would ever want to come into my home and hurt me. You know. So what happens is we don't think on that level that a horse does. And that in details where the problem lies. There's a difference between being hard and firm. There's just a difference between being soft and fair. Okay. Now, make no bones about it. There is not a horse that lives that I'll ever be a victim to. It won't matter. I'll go down with whatever I've got to do. If I've got to bite his nose, I will not be a victim. If he's trying to, that's what I tell him. Be firm to be fair. Know the difference between those four when you move to be there. It's the same thing. Whiskey to tea. So long dissertation to answer your question. You need to mentally get the horse so you have them physically. If they don't mentally think that you could do it, it'd be like, I'm an MMA fighter. Lolly, would you train me to fight next month? See, if I physically don't think that you can do that, then I'm going to be reluctant. Or you may come to me and go, Skinner, I know you're going to go to an MMA fight next month. I want to train you. Okay. So it's that same kind of dissertation. So do something. Don't just sit up there. You know your horse better than anybody. Everybody who's ridden their horse feels something in the horse. When you feel something that doesn't feel right, no, it's not. Trust me. Trust your gut feeling. Your gut feeling is your first instinct. And the horse, hey, listen, the horse trusts his instinct all the time. That's why they run off the buck, they shoulder out, they drop the shoulder in, whatever the case may be. They do all the
same. So it would be forward stuff, and it would be until it then start to relax.
Yep. I would. get them mentally, I would continually work, work, work until that horse goes.
Right.
Whenever I feel that release, mm-hmm. now you're ready. If you have that bound up kind of horse, and most people say, well, they can't tell you how to get that horse relaxed. They may say, well, to get a better lope or a better canter, just keep loping them or canter. That doesn't give you a better lope or better canter. What gives you that is transition from each thing. Once a horse knows that it can do it and it can balance itself and balance you, that's when it gets better. So they understand that and realize that, listen, you're just beating. You know, you're trying to catch fish right here in the middle of this arena. It ain't gonna happen. Okay? What did your dad say?
He's gonna call.
Otherwise,
he said he can't get over
there
for like
4 hours. Okay. All right. I'll just let him know.
I texted her.
Oh, you did? Okay,
yeah.
Great. Thank you.
Thank you.
How's the back?
We'll see.
We'll see.
Okay. Well, like I said, don't put yourself in a bad situation.
No. Yeah, she's gonna be up in a minute. Yeah, we were going to try outside, but it's like we're right on the borderline of the rain line.
Yeah.
So, yeah, and then, of course, they got the pile driver going. Now, they're pretty good in the wind anymore, and the construction pile driver now drives them, drives them nuts.
It's a little bit different.
It drives them all nuts.
Yeah, sure.
Where are you going?
Absolutely.
So. All right. Hey, buddy. You're okay. You're okay, buddy. Calm down, buddy. Okay. I don't want to see that white eye. No white eyes. No white, no white eyes. Okay. Good, huh?
Did you fix your stirrup?
I did not. I didn't do that. First of all, even if I thought about it, I know you'd be on to me.
Well, okay, buddy. Better.
Going. Yeah. I'm really excited about the
pile. Are you ready? Yeah, that's a good way to work. Hey, come on. Give me a head. Whoa. Come here.
see how Dave's back, do you?
Okay. That's a good boy. There you go, better.
Because, you know, a lot of that, what happens is, when we go to push in that stirrup and bring your leg off of the horse can't feel you, you can't feel them, and that's a bit of a problem. Like I was just working with
Come on.
Somebody for y'all. Now do a little bit of a left turn. Real easy. Forward. Now go back to the right. Good. Now a little bit of a circle here. It'll be forward circle. Right. Rotating up. See what he's doing right there?
Mm-hmm.
He's doing that. Pull his head around.